I want to show you six things this morning, and your job is to guess what they have in common. Okay, so I won't be able to hear you, but maybe tell your parents or shout out at the screen, okay? The first one is, of course, Teddy. Okay, so here's Teddy. Now, I've got to show you something else before you think about what it has in common with something. Here's the next thing. It's a packet of hot chocolate or cocoa, okay? What has a teddy and hot chocolate got in common? Here's a book of fairy tales, okay? Any ideas yet? Here's the fourth thing. The fourth thing is a pair of earplugs, the kind of thing you stick in your ears, okay, if you don't want to hear anything. The fifth one, I'm trying to put this on. It's a bit strange. It looks like some medieval torture thing. It's some kind of weird breathing mechanism, okay? Now, there's a reason I'm showing you this. I'll take it off before I knock my microphone off. And the last thing is this. It's a soft, cuddly blanket. Any idea what these things have in common? Well, I'm pretty sure you've guessed. They're all things that help us sleep. Everything that is there helps us to get to sleep. Now, it doesn't mean you have to use all of these things. It doesn't mean that you have to wear that strange thing around your head. But, you know, people like to sleep. Sleep is very important. And not only do these things help us sleep, having a story before bedtime, maybe drinking a cup of cocoa, maybe putting earplugs in, maybe that machine there to stop you snoring, people do all kinds of other things. Maybe they like to have the window open, maybe they like to have the window closed, maybe they have a favorite pair of pajamas, maybe there's a certain time you like to go to bed, maybe there's a position you like to sleep in, all so that we can get the best night's sleep. And sleep is important. But what happens when we can't sleep? Do you know what causes us not to sleep? It's when we worry. It's when we have that thing called stress or anxiety. And at the moment, I think there are people who are a little bit worried because of what's going on around us. You know, people are thinking to themselves, well, I hope I don't catch this virus. I hope nobody in my family catches it. If we do, how long will we have it for? Will there be food in the shops? Will I still have a job at the end of it? All kinds of things that people can worry about. Well, I think things are going okay and there is still food in the shops. But, you know, these are things that can stop people sleeping. And I've heard about people who are stressed by these things and they're finding sleep difficult. What does God say to us about how we can go to bed and sleep each night in peace? King David wrote many of the Psalms. And in Psalm 3, he says something very interesting. Now, at the time, he was being chased by his son Absalom. Now, I'm not talking about a fun game they're having in the park. This was Absalom wanting to take over the kingship. And to do that, he had to kill David first. So Absalom sent his huge army after David, and David had to leave the palace. And he was now living as a fugitive, living and sleeping rough out in the fields, not knowing what the future held. Can you imagine the stress and the worry going through David? First of all, he has this bad situation in his own family. Then he's worried about the future of the kingship, and then he's worried about the thousands of people in the army who are coming after him to take his life. Listen to what David says. He says something very interesting. He says in Psalm 3, I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. There's the first thing we should always do, call out to the Lord. And then he says this, which I think is fascinating. Remember what's going on in his life. He says, I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Now, I like to think that maybe my problems aren't as bad as David's at the moment. And if David is able to sleep, maybe the Lord's encouraging me that I can as well. Remember what the Lord says. He says, do not worry. Cast your cares upon him. Do you remember that story in the Old Testament when Elisha is standing on the walls of the city of Dothan and he looks out and the whole city is surrounded by an army who have come to capture him? While his servant panics and looks at the problem, Elisha reminds the servant, look up and see that the army of God is greater. And he says, greater are those who are with us than those who are against us. Do you remember that occasion when the disciples were panicking on the Sea of Galilee? The storm was so great that they feared for their lives and they shouted out to Jesus, do you not care that we are drowning? What was Jesus doing? In the midst of the same storm that was panicking the disciples, he's there in the front of the boat sleeping. He is able to keep his eyes on God. And what's most fascinating for me is what David says in the next psalm. Listen to this. He says this. He says, I will lie down and sleep in peace, for you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. There are some worrying things around, and sometimes the worries do affect us. But remember what David did. First of all, he called upon the Lord, and he heard back from the Lord. And then he decided to lie down in peace, and he made that decision in his heart, I will not fear.